Thank you. Chicken Nuggets, it's me, Carl.
And I'm Andy.
Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV! Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now once again, welcome to Grow TV!
I can't wait.
Hey, Carl.
Hi, Andy. How are you?
Good. I'm good.
You gonna ask me how I'm doing?
Sure. How are you?
Good. I'm so good. I'm so excited.
Excited? Excited for what?
I thought it was obvious.
What?
That I would be searching for the most elusive and sought-after creature on the planet.
Tony the Tiger?
No, of course not. I'm talking about Bigfoot.
Bigfoot?
Yes, Bigfoot. It's now my mission to find him. Or her.
You mean the mysterious 8-foot creature that lives in the mountains and never been caught?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, even if Bigfoot was real, what makes you think you're qualified to catch such a huge, mysterious, and unusual creature?
How about a letter from the guy who's in charge of the government?
You mean the president?
Yep.
Well, if that was the case, I'd probably believe you, but I highly doubt the president of the United States would ever even... Wait, that letter's from the...
President of the United States asking me, Carl, to lead the search for Bigfoot.
Wow, Carl, I'm blown away. That's, I'm sorry I doubted you. That's crazy.
No worries, Andy. I know it must have seemed pretty unusual. And that's our theme.
Yeah.
Yeah, you definitely pulled a David on me.
Yeah, sure. Wait, a David? What does that mean?
Well, the story of David when he was anointed as king, it was very unusual for many reasons.
Oh. In what ways?
Well, let's look in 1 and 2 Samuel.
David was a king, right?
He was, one of the most famous.
Well, who was the king before David?
Good question. He was a man named Saul.
Oh, I remember him. He was the first king Israel ever had.
That's right, but unfortunately, Saul was not a very good king. But God was going to give Israel a new king.
All right, well, now it's time for King David. You better watch out, King Saul. There's a new king in town.
Well,
what do you mean, well?
Well, yes, King David was a warrior, but before he was known as King David the Great Warrior, he was known first and foremost as Young David the Shepherd Boy.
Whoa, really?
He sure was. King Saul was handsome, he was tall, he was a good warrior. He was basically exactly what you think a king would look like.
So you're saying I look like a king?
Yeah, Carl, that's exactly what I'm saying.
Carry on, my little subject.
Well, God told Samuel, one of the prophets, that it was time to anoint a new king.
What does anoint mean?
It was a special ceremony type of thing that people would do specifically for people who were picked by God or anointed by God.
Got it. So God told Samuel it was going to be David?
Not exactly. God told Samuel to go to Bethlehem and find a man named Jesse.
Hey, I know someone that was from Bethlehem. It started with J.
Is it Jesus?
No.
Okay, you keep thinking about it. Anyway, when Samuel got to Bethlehem, he found the man named Jesse, and he found all of his sons, except for the youngest son, and his name was David. But David wasn't there.
What was he doing?
Like I said before, he was a shepherd, so that means he was out taking care of the sheep.
Awesome, so what happened next?
Well, when Samuel realized that none of the sons there were the ones that he was sent by God to anoint, he asked Jesse if he had any more sons.
So they went and got David?
They sure did, and when Samuel met David, he knew that he was the one that God wanted to be the next king.
That's so cool. So that's the end of the story?
Not even close. You see, David was around 15 years old when he met Samuel.
Wait, what? 15 years old? A king can't be 15 years old? That's a child. That's a baby boy, Andy.
That's what made this so unusual. Not only was David really young, but he was the youngest son, and he wasn't even a warrior like Saul. He was just a boy who took care of sheep.
And he's going to lead the whole kingdom of Israel?
Yep, and this was just the beginning of the amazing story of King David. He became the greatest king in the Bible and a man after God's own heart.
Jesus!
Oh, right, the greatest king after Jesus, of course, yeah.
No, I remember now, Jesus was born in Bethlehem, so...
No way.
Okay, you're right. But how's that possible? Were they related?
As a matter of fact, Carl, they are, and Jesus was born into the family line of David.
Wow, that's unreal. There's so much about David that I didn't know.
Well, good for you. We'll be talking about David all month long, but you know what, Carl?
What?
You know how I didn't believe right away that you were chosen to be the leader for the search of Bigfoot? Well, people found David being chosen as king to be just as unusual.
I guess I never thought about it like that. David was definitely a questionable choice. It's kind of cool how God chooses people that you wouldn't quite expect. They have such important jobs like running the kingdom.
It is very cool. I mean, in the Bible, we see all kinds of people that get to do amazing things for God. People who had no remarkable skills, people who had physical challenges, people without impressive backgrounds, people who might seem unlikely to do great things, but God uses unlikely people.
Amen to that, sister. Wait a minute. That's our big idea. Today's big idea is God uses unlikely people.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. One, two, three.
Three.
God uses unlikely people.
Yeah. Right. Good job, everyone.
Yeah.
Andy?
So I'm curious.
About what?
How do you expect to find a Bigfoot?
Andy, one does not find Bigfoot. Bigfoot finds you.
Okay, and how will Bigfoot find you?
I will be using the Bigfoot call, of course.
Oh. How do you do it?
Let me show you. So basically, you have to put your thumbs kind of like that, you know? Gently cup your hand, and you just kind of like, it's a tight squeeze, but not like too tight, just kind of like, eh. And you just kind of, you open it up a little, and you just go, here, Bigfoot, here, Bigfoot.
Well, I don't see how that won't work. Have a good week, kids. See you next time.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV.
memory verse, memory verse, Chavish. Memory verse, memory verse, memory verse, Chavish.
Ah, yes, a memory verse challenge. Woo woo.
Isaiah 55:8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord.